بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Allah Jalla Jalalu Amma Nawaluhu has given us these amanat and these trusts and given us the keys to the blessings and barakat. Barakat of dunya and akhirah. The worldly blessings are dhimnan, by the way. The real blessing is deen and spreading the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qul in kana aba'ukum. If these things mentioned, whether it's your parents, your children, your wives, your properties, is more beloved to you than أحب إليكم من الله ورسوله وجهاد في سبيله. Allah, His Rasool, ulama explain, Allah and His Rasool is deen, and striving to come and make that alive is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khuruj fi sabilillah. So these two things, the deen of Allah and making efforts so that the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes alive in the world. So each person, generally in the world, when a person has an investment, they've got a retirement plan, then based on a person's capacity, does he invest? So somebody who has only his life savings, that little bit amount of money, I need to invest it carefully. He studies the markets, he studies the different investments, and he cannot afford to take a chance. So he looks for the most secure avenues with the greatest profits and the least risk. Unlike a person who has a lot of capital and wealth, he invests in different ventures, takes risks, and he can afford to lose it. But the first person can't. Allah has given us the wealth of time. And this investment is an investment not for retirement till death, investment for eternity. And the quantity is limited. We only have so many thousand seconds of life, and the retirement is permanent. Yeah, in the world, if a person fails, he loses his money, there is still always a plan B and C, this family, etc. In akhirat, we cannot take the risk. So why are we so particular with regards to the investments of dunya and profits of dunya, but with regards to the investment of akhirah, we are not particular? In the world, we'll have a portfolio manager, we'll have a broker who will advise a person what to do. Their thoughts, their research is dhanni, it's speculation. With regards to akhirah, Allah and His Rasul, وَمَنْ أَسْتَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا وَمَنْ أَسْتَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُ يُوحَىٰ. This is the truth, there's no doubt about it. Yet the people of Iman still have doubt. How much barakah Allah gave to Saba, we cannot fathom and imagine, because they use their time right, they use their wealth right, they use their health, their wealth, their assets correctly. So Allah gave them the trees, treasures of dunya and akhirah. Hazrat Abu Umamah radiallahu anhu Sabi had a Christian slave girl that used to serve him. So he had a habit, he was very generous, spending sadaqah. And any money he saved was for giving it in charity. And his routine was never to ever send a beggar empty-handed, even though he gave him an onion or a date or anything else. Whatever he had, he gave it. So one day a beggar came to him at the time and he had nothing but 3 dinars. The beggar asked, he gave him a dinar. Another beggar came, he asked, he gave him the second dinar. Third beggar came, asked, gave him the last, the third dinar. So the slave girl became very upset and angry, and she said, you have left nothing for us. He didn't say anything, he put his head down and took his qaylula. When adhan for dhuhr went, she woke him up, performed wudu, and he left for the masjid. That day he was fasting. So she said, I felt very sorry for the sabi. I went to take a loan. I prepared supper for him, and we needed some oil for the lantern. And when I went to make his bed, I was surprised to find some gold coins. I counted the coins and there were 300. So she thought, she said, you know, he only did this for show. He had a lot of money. He gave the 3 coins away, but he knew he had a lot of money. So he returned after Isha Salah. He saw the supper, he seen the light, he smiled and saying that this is the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So she remained there by him until he finished his supper. Then she told him, يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكَ يَا أَبَا أُمَامَةَ. That may Allah forgive you. You know, below your pillow, there was 300 coins, min dhahab. There were 300 gold coins. So he was shocked. He said, أَيْنَ لِي بِالذَّهَبَ. It's not possible, I only had the 3 coins. وَقَدْ تَصَدَّقْتُ بِهَا. And I gave it away. So I told him, he said, اِرْفَعَ الْمِخَدَّ فَرَفَعَ فَلَمَّا رَأَ الذَّهَبَ. He went, he looked at the pillow, he inspected it under the pillow. He seen the gold coins and he was shocked and amazed. And he said, مَا هَذَا وَيْهَكَ. What's this? Where did this come from? فَقَالَتْ لَا عِلْمَ لِي. I say, I have no clue. I don't have an idea where it did come from. Aren't you the one? أَلَسْتَ مَنْ وَضَعَهُ. Did you not put it? He said, لَا. So he became more shocked and he became more amazing. He became more shocked and became more amazed and overjoyed and perplexed. So she, as soon as she seen that, she cut off her cross. She accepted Islam. And Ibn Jabir says that I saw the slave girl in the Masjid of Damascus where she was busy teaching the woman Qur'an, Sunnah, Faraid, and educating them about Islam and Deen. So one was the dunyawi benefit, one was the Deeni benefit. Sahaba, even in the dunya, people came close to Allah. Sahaba, in the dunya, people came close to Allah. Allah make us maaf today, even in our Deen, people go far away from Allah. When they look at the people of Deen and their actions, people go far away from Allah. So Barakah, the 20th Asbab and Sabab for Barakah is Dua. So one is we make a Dua, one is the different Adiya which Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam taught us. The Dua for in the early part of the morning for Barakah. Allahumma inni as'aluka khayra hadha al-yawm, fathahu wa nasrahu wa nurahu wa barakatahu wa hudahu. Oh Allah, ask for your goodness of this day, its victory, its help, its light, and its barakah, blessings. Besides that, huda and guidance. And I seek refuge from the evil that is in it and the evil that follows it. A'udhu bika min sharri ma fihi wa sharri ma ba'dahu. So we ask for barakah. Somebody gets married, we make dua for them. Barakallahu laka wa baraka alayka. Again, dua for barakah. Then when we eat by somebody, the host, then dua should be made, Allahumma barik lahum fi ma razaqtahum maghfir lahum warhamhum. Oh Allah, grant blessings. So yeah, again, dua for barakah. Then before Ramadan also, we are asking the same dua, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban. Allah, give us barakah in Rajab and Sha'ban. Give us tawfiq. The actual barakah is barakah in ibadah. When a child, a newborn, then the dua is Barakallah laka fil mawhub. May Allah put barakah in this child progeny. Likewise, we ask for barakah in everything else that is connected to us. Wa barik lana fi asma'ina wa absarina wa qulubina wa azwajina wa dhurriyatina. Amongst the duas that we should be making is, Allah, give us barakah in our yearing, in our seeing, in our hearts, in our wives, in our children. Barakah in everything. Nabi Ali said, may dua, Allahumma barik lana fi shamina wa fi yamanina. Oh Allah, give barakah in Sham, in Yemen, in food. Allahumma barik lana fi ma razaqtana wa kina adhab an-nar. Allahumma give us barakah in what you have provided for us. After eating, alhamdulillahi hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fi. Khayra makfin wa la muwadda'in wa la mustaghnan anhu rabbana. So, mubarakan fi, barakah. Allahumma barik lana fihi. Allah put the barakah in it. When we drink in milk as well. Allahumma barik lana fihi wa zidna min. Allama Manawi has said that فَإِنَّهُ لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ, that there is nothing that will is so beneficial in food and drink than milk. And that's why we're asking for ziyada. Allah increase it. Allahumma barik lana fi ma a'tayta. Ya Allah, whatever you have given us, grant us more. Allahumma la sahla illa ma ja'altahu sahla. Ya Allah, nothing is easy except what you make easy. So different adiya, different du'as for barakah. We find that Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu, he says, my mother once took me to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she said, please make dua. Udu'u Allah lahu. Oh Allah, oh Nabi of Allah, please make dua for this little servant, Khuwaydimuka. Khadim Khuwaydim. This little servant of yours, Khadim, make dua for him. So Nabi alayhi salam made dua. Allahumma akthir malahu wa waladahu wa atil umrahu wa ghfil dhambahu. Oh Allah, increase his wealth and progeny, and increase his life span, and forgive his sins. So the Sahabi says, Anas radiallahu anhu, فَقَدْ دَفَنْتُ مِنْ سُلْبِ, I've buried 98, 102, and in another riwayat, 125 of my children. 125 of my children. And he said, besides that, وَإِنَّ ثَمَرَتِي لَتَحَمِّلُ فِي السَّنَةِ مَرَّتَيْنِ, and in my orchards bear fruits twice a year. Normally everybody else's orchards gives fruits once a year, but I have an orchard that gives fruits twice a year through the barakah in dua. وَلَقَدْ بَقَيْتُ حَتَّى سَئِمْتُ الْحَيَاتِ, and I seen life, so much of life, that Allah, Nabi Islam made barakah in his life as well. So Allah gave him a long life, Allah gave him barakah in his wealth, Allah gave him barakah in his children as well. So dua, the power of dua, we did an entire series on dua, if Allah gives us tawfiq, try to listen to that as well, in the survival guide. Then number 21, waiting for food to cool off. So that's a means of barakah. Asma binti Abi Bakr radiallahu anha, إِذَا ثَرَدَتْ غَدَّتْهُ حَتَّى يَذْهَبَ فَوْرُهُ, that when she would make the thareed and it was done, she would cover it until the steam would terminate. And she used to say, I heard the Nabi of Allah saying, إِنَّهُ أَعْذَمُ لِلْبَرَكَةِ, it is very beneficial for barakah. So leaving the food until the steam disappears and it cools off. Baridu ta'amakum yubarak lakum fihi. That let your food cool off, there will be barakah in it. Likewise, the riwayat of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, la yu'kal ta'am hatta yadhhaba bukharuhu. That don't eat any food until the heat, the very, very strong strength, the heat, when you cook the food, it gets very hot. So until it does not cool and simmer down, then we should not consume from the food. Number 22, to cover the food. وَخَمِّرُوا آنِيَتَكُمْ, that close your containers. غَتُّ الْإِنَى وَأَوْكُ السِّقَى, that the containers close it, the water bottles, put the lids on it. فَإِنَّ فِي السَّنَةِ لَيْلَةً يَنْزِلُ فِيهَا وَبَعَى, Because in the year, there is a time where calamities, sicknesses come. لَا يَمُرُّ بِإِنَاءٍ لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ غِطَاءٍ. And when that descends, and if there is no covering, if the food is left open, إِلَّا نَزَلَ فِيهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ الْوَبَىٰ. That calamity falls. So in the year, there is one day where these calamities fall. If a person is unfortunate to have had a container open and they consume from that, then there may be some devastating consequences. حِفْظًا لَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. And likewise, it's a protection from the shayateen also. So we need to cover the food, cover the pots also. When we're done eating, then the dastarkhan, before we leave, the food needs to be removed. When it is put away, it shouldn't be left open. The containers need to be closed. Number 23, to be happy with the distribution of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يَبْتَلِي عَبْدَهُ بِمَا أَطَاهُ. Allah tests you with the sustenance. فَمَنْ رَضِيَ بِمَا قَسَّمَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ تَعَالَى لَهُ. That whoever is happy with the decision of Allah, there'll be barakah. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لَهُ فِيهِ وَوَسَّعَهُ. Allah will put blessings. Allah will increase it. Allah will make it vast. Allah will make it last. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَرْضَى لَمْ يُبَارِكْ لَهُ فِيهِ. And whoever is ungrateful with the sustenance that Allah has provided, there will be no barakah. مَنْ كَانَ هَمْهُ الْآخِرَةِ. Whoever's concern is akhirah. جَمَى اللَّهُ شَمْلَهُ. All his efforts, Allah will gather it. So what will take 1 month? You'll do it in 1 day. What 100 rand will do, you'll do it in 1 rand. وَجَعَلَ غِنَاهُ فِي قَلْبِي. Allah will put contentment in his heart. وَأَتَتُ الدُّنْيَا وَهِيَ رَاغِمَةٌ. And dunya will come to his feet. Disgraced, take me, take me. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ. And whoever's fikr and worry and concern is dunya, فَرَّقَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ شَمْلَهُ. Allah will distribute his efforts. 1 day's work, 2 days' work, so will take a month, 2 months, 5 months. The money that you have, 1,000 rand, you could have done it 100 rand. 5,000 rand is not enough. وَجَعَلَ الْفَقْرَ بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ. And you will only see poverty. وَلَمْ يَأْتِهِ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَا كُتِبَ لَهُ. And whatever has been destined, he'll only get that. مَنْ أَصْبَحَ وَالدُّنْيَا أَكْبَرُ هَمِّهِ. If a person's worry is only dunya, فَلَيْسَ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْءٍ. Allah takes no responsibility. وَأَلْزَمَ اللَّهُ قَلْبَ أَرْبَ خِصَالٍ. 4 azabs, 4 punishments. هَمَّنْ لَا يَنْقَتِي عَنْهُ أَبْدًا. He will have grief, worry, anxiety. Every time you see him, problems, parishani, distress. All the time, his whole life is full of stress. وَشُغْلًا لَا يَتَفَرَّغْ مِنْهُ أَبَدًا. He'll be so busy and engaged, there'll be never ever time in his life. He will become engaged, busy, no time. وَفَقْرًا لَا يَبْلُغُ عِنَاهُ أَبَدًا. Such poverty, it will never reach richness, غِنَاهُ أَبَدًا, ever. And إِمْلَالًا لَا يَبْلُغُ مُنْتَهَاهُ أَبَدًا. And he will tie himself. So much tiredness that it'll know no limits. So Sahaba had understood their responsibility. Wealth was not their priority. So Allah gave them barakah. Riwayat Abu Huraira, his Sahabi went home and he seen there was nothing. So he went out. فَلَمَّا رَأَتْ إِمْرَأَتُهُ قَامَتْ إِلَى الرَّحَى. So when the wife seen that situation, then she went to the grinding stone, she set it up and she went to the oven and lit it. Then she made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma rizukna. O Allah, provide for us. O Allah, provide for us. فَنَذَرَتْ فَإِذَا الْجَفْنَةُ قَدْ امْتَلَأَتْ. When she looked, she saw the oven was full with bread. When her husband returned, he asked her, was anything happening? She said, yes, Mir Rabbina, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He then went to the grinding stone, lifted it. Because of that, the grinding stone stopped and the flour stopped being produced. So they went to Nabi alayhi salatu was salam. They reported it and he told them, أَمَا إِنَّهُ لَوْ لَمْ يَرْفَعْهَا لَمْ تَزَلْ تَدُورُ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. if you do not open it and check what was happening, it would have continued grinding and flour would have been produced till Qiyamah. Such power in dua and amal of nubuwa that mal would have produced flour till the day of Qiyamah. So Barakah, these are avenues where we can draw from the khazana, where we can draw from the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunate is a person who has not been favored with this bounty. The amal for today is to give sadaqah in secrecy. Ibn Abi al-Ja'i say, "Inna sadaqah latadfa'u sab'ina baban min as-su'." That sadaqah dispels 70 doors of calamities in harm. وَفَضْلُ سِرِّهَا عَلَىٰ نِيَّتِهَا سَبْعِينَ ضِعْفًا. And to spend secretly compared to publicly, the difference is 70 times. So when we give sadaqah, let's try to give sadaqah secretly. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.